Our home was a very happy home, always filled with music. So all my life with my dad is nothing but music.
I was born in 1932 in Singapore. My grandfather and the whole family came from Philippines. My grandfather used to play for the silent movie those days. So he played the piano. That's why he came down here to work. And all the family followed. And all my uncles, my aunties, all are musicians. My father know that my brother liked to play the piano, and sometimes I also go and disturb him playing the piano. So he knows they show interest, and we got good sense of rhythm. Then he told me, he teach my brother the piano, and I took the violin. My father taught me the violin. Well, my first band was, I call it the Marvel Boys. We started about 15 years old, I was 16 years old, I started. Because my father's musician friend, the children all play music, they like music. They used to come to the house very often, so we used to jam session. So one day, my father said, "Your plus one, jam, do something about it." He told me. So, okay, I started getting the boys to perform. We played Shackle Club, British Club. Only once we played at Great Wall Cabaret, and once we played at Lido's Nightclub. Then my uncle Jerry, who called me to work with him in Raffles Hotel. And from there onwards, I learned to play proper drumming because why? A lot of foreign flow shows come down and perform. So I learned from them. Most of the dancers, the flow show dancers come in from Philippines. They do nothing but Latin. From there, I start playing the Latin and I find out the Latin, very good, a good rhythm brings up, you know, it makes you feel, want to move. So I started from that time onwards. I started playing Latin, and then when I worked in radio, I started doing my own program called Latin Six. In late 70s and the 80s, all these big stars coming down to Singapore, like Shirley Bassey, Matt Monroe, Johnny Ray, all. I jammed with Buddy Rich, the fastest drummer in the world. We had a jam session with him, and he taught me some tricks of the drums. So I played for all of them. The last person I played for was Sammy Davis Jr. But I didn't play the drum, I played percussion. When I had a second stroke, I was blind for half a day. Then the surgeon came and talked to me. He said, "You had a second stroke, Mr. Swan, but you're lucky." I said, "I had a stroke, I'm lucky." He said, "Yes, because you got no blood clot. How do you get paralyzed?" So I said, "Oh, I see." Okay. Then later on, my daughter to the doctor and told her, he said, "I'm coming in for a very big nervous breakdown." He said, "So there's no medicine, no cure for it." Then he asked my daughter, "What do I do? What is my..." So my daughter said, "I'm a musician, I'm a drummer," and all this. He plays music, right? He said, "Give him back his music and see what he..."
And this thought came about, ask him if he would compose some songs. And then I asked him, so I said, "Dad, would you compose some songs if I ask you to?" Then he looked at me in a very funny way and he says, "I'll try." Then I said, "Okay, if you can come up with at least 12 songs, I promise you, beg, steal or borrow, I'll try and get the CD going for you." And immediately he bounced back.
I did 12 songs and I did the CD. In 2 weeks, all the 12 songs was ready. So we went to do the pressing and that's how the CD just came out, just released. And all the song, I titled them my grandchildren, all different names, except my daughter, Jacinta, she's the only one. That's all my grandchildren.
The most important thing that he has given to me is music.
It's heartening to see that his last three grandkids, to see them learning from him. They're learning from the best.
They are very fortunate.
Well, like I said before to somebody, I said I learned my music at age of 8, and now I'm 81. All the way through, nothing I know but except music. I play music, I write music, and I love music. And I'm very glad that I'm a musician. I don't regret.